Here's the best way to spy on your competitor's campaign and do research to set yourself up for success. This is a segment from a longer Facebook ads course I have on YouTube. I recommend you watch this video, then click that longer training, and it's so easy to skip past the part you've already watched. We're gonna start by doing some brainstorming and finding inspiration, and this should really be an ongoing process. For my customers and clients, we're doing like 10, 20, 30, sometimes even 100 new ads per month, just because you need to constantly be innovating and keep things fresh and working really well. So how do you even get started? The first thing you can do is go to facebook.com/ads/library. And we want to switch to search all. And you can look up your competitors. You can also look up people in your industry. So I do a lot with like food and beverage. So we can just do HelloFresh for this example. You can choose the country and the platform. I usually like to keep it at all platforms. So what you can do is you can actually see the ads that they're running. Now, know that this isn't necessarily all the ads that they're running. For some reason, sometimes stuff doesn't show up, like some ad campaigns I've looked up on here where I know we've got like 100 ads going and it shows like 2. So they may be running a lot more than this, but this gives us a good indication of the various things that they're running. You can look at like colors, the type of photos. You know, typically people use like photos of people work really well, but they've got these really nice product shots. We also want to look at sort of a ratio of photos to video. So if it's like a course or something like that, informational, coach, consultant, probably like 80% are gonna be videos. If it's something very, very visual and simple and easy to understand, like HelloFresh or food, I find sometimes with that you have like 60, 70, 75% of them are photos. So you can actually watch all these videos. What I like to do is I like to take a screenshot of the various photos. I like to do a screenshot because then I can actually see like the button and the headline and things like that. And then I always move them to, I have like an inspiration folder on my desktop. And if it's a video, you can actually start playing the video and then right click, at least on Chrome, and you can actually save the video. So I'm constantly updating a creative folder, and it's not necessarily to copy people, but it's to just provide inspiration. And sometimes you can innovate it or make it your own and make it even better than the initial one. But I always recommend looking up someone who's kind of a big player in your industry, even if they're not a direct competitor. You do want to think about, sometimes companies of different sizes have different priorities. Like if you're a new soft drink company, you may just be trying to get as many sales as possible, whereas someone like Coke may just kind of build brand awareness and get people to like their brand and stuff like that. Now, it starts with the most recent ads, and then at the bottom is going to be the ones launched the furthest back. So I always like to look at what ads are the furthest back. What's the earliest ones that we have? The reason I do this is this was launched in July. You know, I'm recording this late October. So it's been running close to half a year, not quite half a year. If this ad was not making money, they would not be running it. You're not gonna run an ad that is unprofitable for over half a year. Whereas some of the stuff that just launched, you really, scrolling back up to the top, have no idea. They've just launched this, it may tank for them. It may be losing them money and they just have it going for a couple days. So stuff at the bottom is actually a better indicator of what's made them the most money or what they've seen is the most effective. With video, you wanna kind of see the elements they're including. You also want to kind of see the different lengths, see if what platforms they're running on it on, things like that. You can also do like a spreadsheet or something like that. Like you can save like headlines or body text or different call to actions or things like that, stuff that you find inspiring. If it's mainly just the text, that's another way to keep track of what's working really well. So we have a good idea of the various ads that they're doing. You know, this ad is just 9 seconds long, but we don't really know the audiences that they're using. And we also don't know, you know, if this ad was shown to someone who visited one of the pages or started a checkout or liked them on Facebook or anything like that, or if it's just shown to huge, broad audiences, people who have never heard of them before. So I actually like also going to the website and kind of seeing, okay, do they have an offer, the way it's structured. Sometimes I'll even go to check out and then not complete the checkout because a lot of times they'll have like an abandoned cart, and I'll look at the different pages because it's likely that I will start receiving retargeting ads from them. So then I can kind of keep track of this. I can add it to the spreadsheet, you know, to kind of track along a single brand, like the different ads that they showed to me. I actually almost always buy their product, buy the competitor's products, just so I can see kind of what kind of emails they send, how frequently they send them, what happens if I abandon the cart, just that whole process. You really want to think about if they're doing something that you're not doing that's driving a lot of purchases, they're going to outcompete you. So you want as few things where you're falling behind as possible. Okay, so we got this pop-up offer right here. So I would, you know, write it down. You can make a Google Doc or a spreadsheet just for HelloFresh if that's who you're targeting. So they're trying to get the email to give you a bonus. If you do this top one, you get the same kind of opt-in. They have a countdown timer, which I'm sure never actually expires. It's always available. So when I'm scrolling through Facebook, I am always just saving things that look really cool, things that stop me from scrolling, that catch my eye, things like that. So I have, you know, a list of, you know, 100 different ads that I found really inspiring or attention grabbing or things like that. That's actually not a bad image. Bright colors that pop. So what you can do, you can actually save the link so you can save it for later to view. I usually do screenshot just because sometimes they delete an ad and then you can't access it anymore. Actually, under the ads library, you can actually copy a link to the ad so you can send someone a link to the ad. The only problem is if it no longer becomes active, if they pause the ad, sometimes you can't see it again in the future, which is a big bummer, which is why I always like to save a screenshot and actually have it on my hard drive because that's never going anywhere. So the final thing you want to do is actually go to your Facebook page and Instagram page and look through all of the comments and see what people are talking about, what frustrations they have, anything that's keeping them from buying, testimonials, people saying great things, people highlighting the things that they like. It's much, much better if it's actually for your page, your actual customers talking. If you don't have a following, I'd recommend building one up, building that community. It's really helpful for running Facebook ads, Instagram ads. If you don't have a following, actually look up one of your competitors and read through all of their comments. So I just pulled up the very first thing that showed up for me. So I'm going to pretend that this is my page and my brand. So I'd go through and just look through the comments and actually spend 20 minutes, 30 minutes, depending how many there are. Seeing what people are discussing. This can also give you ideas for audiences. You know, this woman says she's a nurse, keeps me full during my shift. So I would definitely take a screenshot of that. And I would also grab the text and punch it into my thing, like testimonials, things for my page. It's up to you how you want to organize this, but just so you're saving that so you can reference it at any point in the future, because this is knowing your audience, really understanding what they care about, the reasons they aren't buying, you know, where can I read reviews? So making that really obvious. And just the more time you spend on this, the better you'll get to know your audience, the better you'll get in the next step, which is actually like writing the copy and planning out the ads. So I would recommend grabbing 15, 20, 30 ads for inspiration, other people who are competitors in your industry, any other ads that just are really inspiring, really creative. I usually try to go through Facebook really quickly and see what stops my scroll, stops me in my tracks that I want to pay attention to, or even something. Anything you click on, definitely save, because that actually inspired you to click on it to learn more. And then actually go to your comments section for Facebook and Instagram if you have any sort of following, and go through and read all of people's frustrations, their discussions, their testimonials, who they are, you know, what they care about, really jot that down. If you don't have a following, actually go to your competitors and figure that out.
Now that you have this research done, you'll want to go to this larger Facebook ads training that will help you create the ads and launch the entire campaign. It's so easy to skip past this first part. I will see you in that tutorial now. Give this a like if it was helpful. Thanks. I'll see you in that video.